Are you looking to use video and YouTube for your creative small business? Well, in this video, I'm going to be hosting Trina Little, a YouTube marketing strategist for creatives, who's going to be sharing all about getting started using YouTube and how to gain confidence on the camera. Hi, I'm Vanessa Kynes, and I'm a Pinterest marketing strategist for creative small businesses, and I help creative businesses craft traffic-generating Pinterest marketing strategies so they can get back to their unique creative work. And in my own business, I have seen the powerful effects of using YouTube and video marketing to reach new audiences. I'm super excited to be hosting Trina Little on my channel today, and I can't wait for you to learn more about how to use video.
Thank you so much, Vanessa, for letting me talk to your community about getting started on YouTube. So if we haven't met before, hi, my name is Trina, and I help a lot of female business owners get started on YouTube, but more importantly, how to create a strategy for using YouTube to grow your business. So whether that's to get more clients or to get more email lists or to get more people into your webinar, that's kind of my zone of genius. And I totally get it. I'm a business owner with lots of things on my business to-do list, plus a mom. So I also have kids to take care of. And so running out of time is something that happens quite frequently here. So you're probably wondering, how are you going to find time to do video? Well, finding time is the first key part to getting started on YouTube. You just gotta commit to making the time to do it, and then you'll realize how you can take this one YouTube video and really utilize it across Instagram, Instagram stories, Instagram TV, Facebook, in your email sequence to really help you get the biggest bang for your buck with one video. Because look, I don't look like this all the time. Thank goodness there are Instagram filters because I am not washing my hair and I'm not putting makeup on. So when you have that video where you commit to doing your hair and makeup maybe once a month, that's really gonna allow you to get your face out to more places, building your visibility and looking like you're constantly creating content when you really only do it once a month. So how can you get started on YouTube? Well, my first tip is to create a plan. I always go back to that quote that says, fail to plan, plan to fail. I plan everything, and when I don't plan my weekends, I end up getting nothing done. And so I always have a plan for when I'm going to shoot YouTube videos. I know the kids need to be out of the house if I'm going to shoot. I know it needs to be a day that I can actually get my hair and makeup done, and I know it needs to be a day where I don't have calls scheduled on my calendar. The only way you're going to start on YouTube is if you actually carve out the time in your schedule to create videos. And it doesn't have to be super difficult. You only really need to post one video a week on YouTube to see results. So that's only one video a week. 4 videos in 1 month. So if you can commit to one day a month just sitting down and shooting 4 videos, you now could have YouTube content that is also Facebook content and Instagram content and Pinterest content. So once you actually start creating time for video and you make a plan, your second step is to choose the right videos. And what I mean by that is choosing the right topics. Because people aren't necessarily going to YouTube for the lingo or the vocabulary you might be using. You may be very into your niche or your topic in your business, and people might not be searching that. So for example, with Vanessa, if you're brand new to Pinterest, you may not know about Tailwind. So when she's publishing things about Tailwind, it may help her reach a broader audience if she would talk about Pinterest schedulers or how to schedule pins or how to grow your Pinterest account, right? Because we may not know that Tailwind vocabulary yet. Just like if I start throwing out some YouTube terms, you're probably not searching that, but you're probably searching how to create videos, how to upload to YouTube. So the first place you want to go in looking for these topics is your blog content. What are the top 10 blog posts that you have? What's getting a lot of traffic? What are people coming to? Those are the places you want to get started. You also want to start simplifying that word. You don't want to get too very niche and specific because you're not going to bring new people to your content if you're getting too specific because they're not searching for that. So back to that example where I said instead of saying how to use Tailwind to grow your Pinterest, maybe it's just 5 strategies to grow your Pinterest, and you talk about Tailwind or you talk about a Pinterest scheduler. So once you have your topic ideas, the next step or tip number 3 is to script your videos. Now, I know you may not want to script videos. This may take a lot of time, but especially if you're getting started on YouTube, you have got to have a game plan when you turn your camera on. Trust me, I've been there. I've turned my camera on, thought I can totally talk about this topic and bust it out in no time. But then you kind of start forgetting where you're going, you lose track, you get on a tangent, and it ends up taking you more time to shoot a video. If you want to be as effective as possible when you're shooting content, you have got to have a game plan, and that's creating a script. Another reason you need to have a script is because a certain format works best on YouTube. People, to grow their know, like, and trust with you, need to watch your video. And if they aren't staying to watch, they're not going to know, like, and trust you. So you really need to open your video with a hook. You need to be on that video as soon as they click on your video on YouTube, and you need to give them a reason why they're going to watch. What are you going to do in this video to help solve their pain point? Why do they need to watch to the end of this video? You've really got to hook them in that first 5 to 15 seconds. Then you want to also make sure your content flows easily. Is it in steps or tips? Not like me, where I'm going back from steps and tips and not remembering which one I said. But you want to make it easy to follow so that they watch longer. They can then take action at the end of the video and see, wow, this person really taught me how to do XYZ. I'm going to go learn more about them or watch another video or sign up for your email list. This next tip really gets people wrapped up in its video equipment. And for this reason alone, today for this video, I'm shooting with a webcam. Now, I normally shoot with my Canon G7X, which is a camera that shoots in HD. It has a flip-up screen so I can make sure I see myself and I'm not blurry on the screen. But you can start with a webcam. I also have a microphone that I use for podcast episodes and all other things right here to my side, my Blue Yeti, and that's what I'm talking into. And I'm shooting this directly onto my laptop. I'm using QuickTime, so it's all one file. And so all I need to go do once I'm done with this is clip out the pauses that I'm taking. So I'm actually just saying a couple sentences at a time and then pausing to recollect myself and to figure out what I'm saying next by looking at my script. But for you, it looks like I'm continuously talking and I'm adding in these jump cuts. So I'm taking out the pauses and it jumps from clip to clip to clip. So it looks more exciting and engaging. And that's all I'm really using. It's really bright outside today, so the sunlight is my light, my webcam is my camera, and my microphone that I use for everything is plugged into my laptop, and that's all I have. You can even get started with your phone. It doesn't have to be as difficult as we make it out to be. Just creating video content really allows people to get to know, like, and trust you faster than any other medium there is. Then the final piece, the final step, the final tip to all of this, if you're getting started on YouTube, is to just publish a video. Look, you see that sign back there? Perfect isn't done. And that's what I want you to remember. You can try and make sure everything is perfect. You have the perfect background, you have the perfect hair color, you have the perfect makeup, you have the perfect lighting, but that is not done. When you post a video to YouTube, whether it's perfect or not, you are gonna get very valuable data from YouTube. They're going to tell you, does your thumbnail and your title entice people to click on it? Does your video keep people watching? Maybe the way you're structuring your video isn't going to work. But you don't know that until you put a video up, until you tweak that video based on the analytics that YouTube gives you. Also, is your topic too broad? Do people even want to watch your topic? Again, you're not going to figure out this information until you just start posting YouTube videos. And here's the secret. Your first videos aren't going to be perfect. They're probably going to be pretty craptastic, but I want you to know we all start there. You can go to my very first videos. They are quite cringeworthy, but I leave them up for you to see. We all have to start somewhere. You are never going to get better until you do this a couple of times. It's just like you're never going to ride a bike if you don't get on that bike, right? And when you jump on that bike, you're not gonna jump on two wheels and instantly go down the biggest hill in the neighborhood. You're gonna fall a couple times. You're gonna crash a couple times. But the more you get back up and the more you do it, the better you're going to get. So you are coasting and cruising down that largest hill in your neighborhood. And when I'm talking YouTube, the better you're going to get at your videos and the more happier and the more confident you're going to be with your videos if you just keep doing it.
Thank you, Trina, for sharing your wisdom and how-to. If you're looking for more video marketing tips and using YouTube, be sure to follow Trina Little on YouTube. If you're looking for more Pinterest marketing strategies, subscribe to my channel below or sign up for my free Pinterest startup guide where you will receive 9 tasks for getting started for using Pinterest to drive traffic to your website or maybe even your future YouTube channel. Thank you so much.